Still an important piece of business to take care of, the extra point. And that will make this a four-point game. So after the punt return touchdown, let's see what their opponents can do with this kickoff. Fairly short kick taken at the 14 here. And it's a pretty good return here as he'll get it up to the 29-yard line. Back out onto the field now comes the New Orleans offense. And they're coming off a three and out, my friend.
I think they've got to look at that play sheet and go to a spot that they haven't gone before. Time to shake things up a little bit to try and get this offense moving.
Okay, so how do you do that? How do you shake things up?
You look at what you've called before, realize it hasn't worked so well.
Go to something else.
And maybe try and find one of those special plays from one of your better players and maybe try and hit something big and get things going in the excitement area.
He's back to throw. Caught on the left side by Ginn. And he'll be brought down at the 45-yard line. 7 yards, the pickup on the pitch and catch. Back to throw. And brought in here by Flaner. And he gets it inside the 35 and just shy of the 30. A good gain of 14 there, and it moves the chains. Back to throw. He's going to flip one out here to his running back. 11 more yards that go around, a first down as well. That's what they need right now. Get the first down, get out of bounds, stop the clock.
Just playing smart football, understanding the situation, making the plays necessary, and making sure that clock stops at every opportunity.
They'll look to throw. And this is caught. Touchdown. And they've taken the lead here in the final minute.
So many practices that we've watched over time where the offense works on scoring late in the game and finding a way to win, as we just saw there.
Just saw it right there. Now can they preserve that advantage that they just got? Morstead, the punter, out to kick it off. This is fielded at the goal line. Spins by. It'll bring it back to just about the 25. Call it the 24-yard line. The Seahawks offense now, they get set to go back to work. They only need a field goal. Obviously, the clock, a huge factor. They'll be watching that. What do they need to do here, Charles?
Your sequence of plays has to get you out of bounds. Completions, get out of bounds, gain some yardage. Then when the clock hits 7 seconds or less.
Now the ball comes loose. And now we won't see a play on first down. We're going to get a timeout instead, as they stop it with 22 ticks to go in the fourth. And this is one of those bang-bang plays, Charles. Did the knee hit first or did the ball come out first?
This is where you need that 20-20 eyesight, don't you, Brandon? You've got to see which one happened first. If the knee hit the ground, then they will keep possession.
Offense comes to the line now, first and 10. And on the outside, they're playing press coverage. He'll look to throw. And he can't get a throw off. He's taken down. down. What a huge play at this point in the game. Cameron Jordan in there to drop him as the clock continues to roll. Now Wilson steps away. Graham displaying the strength. They'll tussle for it, and this is going to be caught. And now with 4 seconds left, we get a timeout call. So here we go. Maybe the biggest kick of the game forthcoming. And now with 4 seconds left, we get a timeout call. So now one of the biggest kicks of the night is forthcoming. 4 seconds to go. This would send us to overtime. And I tell you what, he got it from 58. That had lots of leg behind it. 4 quarters not enough. We're all even, and overtime we go.
How much fun is this for everyone who's watching the game? How much fun is it for us to see this one get an extra period to get settled?
And an overtime playoff game, but the rules, they stay the same as they did in the regular season.
That's exactly right. Whoever scores first, unless it's a touchdown, the other team has a chance to match. That's how it really gets played out. But remember this, no matter how far we go in overtime,